Jack Martin, KRAZ-TV. Well, we got a mask if we need it. We don't really need it, but if it did, my mask says, give it to me by Citizen Zero. Government is sick, not me. But anyway, we're here at the Fire Truck Fire Brewing, Fire Truck Brewing Company. I understand it's a brand new beer company, and they have a thing called Beer Club for Men, which, well, okay, we'll go with that. Anyway, I was listening to KNST. As a journalist, I listen to all the radio and TV programs to get a handle on things. We are an independent journalist arm, but they're supposed to have something down here between 4 and 7, and Garrett Lewis, I know him by a person who knows his parents. He'll probably say something about that. But anyways, we're down here to check this out and do a site check and see if we can come back later and do a live show from Fire Truck Brewing Company here in the shopping center that contains those people. Of course, they said come down and give them hell, but I won't do that, but other people can if they want. But anyway, we're just here as a news gathering and, well, we interview everybody, and we're here at Fire Truck as KRAZ-TV. Well, it appears Sentinel Brewing Company has got the gates to this Fire Truck Brewing Company. Oh, by the way, at KRAZ-TV, we have a fire department, a playlist. So you can go there, go to their central museum, all the bronzes and all of our fallen heroes. Well, folks, I'm inside Fire Truck, and I just talked to some great guys here, and they said come back about 4:30, and yeah, I do have a mask, and you know what it says. Citizen Giro gave that to me. But anyway, Garrett and a few other people, what'd you say your other guy's name? Taylor. We'll be here at 4 to 4:30, and from inside this lovely place. Now, it used to be Sentinel, and now they've changed it to Fire Truck Brewing. So here is their website. Go check that out and use the QR code. Wow, I got some wonderful swag here. It's Sentinel Peak Brewing Company and the Sentinel Peak Brewing Salida del Sol, Exit of the Sun. They're here at their little restaurant at the corner of Grant and Swan. So I'm gonna be back later. I probably go do some plumbing for some people that need it. But anyway, from Fire Truck Brewing, that's right. Look at their merchandise. And we'll get an address for you so you can go to their .com or .net. Use the QR code and you'll know their address. See you from KRAZ-TV inside Fire Truck Brewing Company. Down here at Grant and Swan. And this is our final parting shot from Fire Truck Brewing Company. And we'll be back at 4:30. Hi, Doc Martin for KRAZ-TV. Well, there he is. There's Garrett. Well, Garrett Lewis, he's a personality at KNST. And we're going to be interviewing him. He took my number and name and everything. He said he'd love to have it on. So we're going to talk to management and Tyler and see if, well, we can meet somebody and get an interview here. We're down here. It's pretty busy at the Fire Truck Brewing Company here in Tucson. Hi, I'm the lone journalist from KRAZ-TV. Not crazy, but keep real A to Z. Well, I just talked to Taylor, and he's going to give us an interview when he gets a chance. And Garrett Lewis.
Who's Taylor?
Well, Taylor is one of the managers.
Okay.
So we're going to give him an interview too, and he's just so busy. I mean, we're just now breaking in on this at 4 o'clock, and there's people down here doing little birthdays, and we want to wish everybody. But we don't show people's faces unless they want, unless they give us an interview. But other than that, we're strictly journalists, and we don't do ambush journalism either. Well, there's no mask down here at the Fire Truck Brewing, but I did get this. Patriot Party of Arizona. StopTheRhinos.com. I don't know if that's a misspelling or that's just what it is, rhinos. Well, anyways, Garrett's over there. Daniel, he's the original founder. founder of the Patriot Party here in Arizona, but it's turned over to a guy named Steve. So he'll be here at 6 o'clock. I may or may not be here. But if we can get a chance to have an interview with Garrett Lewis of KNST, we will. And if not, well, come on down to the Fire Truck Brewing Company. It used to be Centennial Brewing Company here in Tucson. So that's where we're at here. Hey, there's a KNST guy,
yes,
too.
Sir.
All right. I don't know who he was, but I think he's the guy who runs the board. So that's where we're at, Fire Truck Brewing Company. Hi, I'm the lone journalist for KRAC-TV. And here's a pin. That's probably mine. But we're down here at the Fire Truck Brewing, and it's just so busy, I'm amazed that, there's so many people who still believe in patriotism, the Constitution, and freedom, and they're expressing themselves, and they're eating. So why do we need a mask here, right? Well, anyways, I have a mask, and it says, government is sick, not me. Anyways, enough about me. Garrett Lewis, the host of KNST, is really busy, and Daniel is the head of the Patriot Party here in Arizona. He'll be here at 6 o'clock, and some other people, and Taylor, is one of the managers here at Fire Truck. He said he would give me an interview when he gets time, but he is slammed. So we may have over 1,000 people down here today, and well, I don't need to be in anybody's way, but keep freedom on your heart and in your mind. Well, this gentleman has a sign. Tell them all, no mask, trust God, not government. Psalm 118, verse 8.
That psalm says, it is better to put your trust in God than in man.
And my mask says, government is sick, not me.
Amen.
Thank you, brother. Well, it's really been a real day down here, and I'm glad to see so many patriots. Well, here we are, folks.
Now,
just a moment. Yeah. No,
you know,
we're not ambush journalists. Hi,
the
I'm Doc Martin for KRAZ-TV. I'm a hitter with an interesting fellow. We want to hear his take on things. He has a wonderful sign, as you can see, and we'll listen to him. He's from Boston, and I give him joint rights, and you let me film this. Is that correct?
Sure, go right ahead.
Go ahead.
As long as you do not edit.
I do not edit.
Sure, so I was a history teacher in Massachusetts, and I was explaining that even before the word cancel culture was put into the lexicon, I was canceled out and told that I didn't fit in my history room was an open classroom. And the objective is always to lead children to the truth, at least give them an appetite for wanting the truth, because there is such a thing as truth.
How long ago was that?
Well, that was 2017 that I left. And so I'm going to be inserting myself into the schools here in Arizona. I'm going to form an organization. I'm going to develop a website, probably called Truth Be Told. Now, this is Easter weekend, and I will tell you that I am a follower of Christ. And for us Christians, the truth begins with a person, and that is the person of Jesus Christ. But because I'm a Christian, I don't tell other people to shut up.
Right.
Because I don't agree with
right,
them.
Exactly.
Okay? And neither did Jesus.
That's
okay.
Right. And so, neither did Buddha either.
You know, I rebuke lies, and kids are being lied to. And the curriculum needs to be investigated. Kids are being told all kinds of lies, especially this LGBT assault.
Q.
Assault on the very innocence of kids.
I know.
It began with same-sex marriage, and I was in Massachusetts with an organization called Mass Resistance. I was part of the startup, although not the boss. The head of Mass Resistance is an incredible fighter named Brian Kammerker, who happens to be an Orthodox Jew.
Yeah.
And we were getting the truth out about what was happening in the schools with same-sex marriage. And by the way, the nation has been lied to by all kinds of people, including Republicans, who covered for Mitt Romney, because Mitt Romney is the sole creator of same-sex marriage. He's the author, the father.
But he's a Mormon.
Well, you see, Mormonism is a cult.
Well,
and the thing is, Mort Barmy, besides being a Mormon, he's a liar. Alan Keyes rightfully called him a liar.
The Supreme Court, much to what everybody thinks, that created same-sex marriage, they didn't. The Supreme Court in Massachusetts acknowledged that they didn't have the right to do it under our state constitution. Romney went right around and ordered the town clerks,
based on the quote-unquote new law, to create same-sex marriage. And there was never a new law.
Was he a governor of Massachusetts?
He was the governor. He came.
Oh, now that's, I want to know why you're so intimate, well, because he's your governor.
He came to Massachusetts to run for president.
Oh.
He spent his first 3 years in the state house, and then he left. And he campaigned around the money and sprinkled tens of millions of dollars in 2007. To try to get endorsements, and his money bought a lot of endorsements at that time. And you know, I can remember meeting Bill Bennett, the former Secretary of Education, in Washington, D.C., telling him about Mitt Romney face to face, privately, and he said, "Well, why don't you call into my talk radio show?" And I did, and he slammed me instantly because, you know, that radio network had already been bought.
Compromised.
By Mitt Romney.
Certainly.
I went into Trader Joe's. I even had a face shield, and they came over to me, and they gave me a basket that had a sign that said, "No mask accommodation." I said to another guy, "What's this?" He goes, "It's like this cardinal letter." I went into Beyond Bread, and they told me I need to wear a mask. I said, "Governor Ducey said that the mask mandate is no more.
It's over."
"Well, guess what?" I said, "But that was illegal anyways, because if not legislated." Peggy Hall, healthyamerican.org. "When they tell you to wear a mask, it's a felony. When they're wearing a mask, it's another crime. And we need to take back our, our tyrannical government. We need to take back we the people."
I was a teacher, history teacher in Massachusetts, and I told the kids years ago, we've become we the sheeple.
No longer we the people. I used to sing the song, what's that Beatles song about? "We're the lonely sheeple."
The lonely people,
yeah.
So, you know,
we have to get a little more aggressive.
Vantage West Credit Union on Craycroft. I went in there with a shield, right? This is before even the mandate. You know, I'm trying to live my life, right? And you know what happened? I wore a shield, and I said, "Yeah, I have an appointment, but I'm a little late." She looks, goes in the back, she goes, "Oh, you aren't on." She's real mean. And she goes, "You need to wear a mask." I said, "I'm wearing a shield, it's safer than your mask."
So I have a question for you. Where do our rights come from?
They come from the Lord.
Praise God.
Amen.
Okay, so, you know, I told my students that. I taught in a secular school. But that's a fact.
I'm radical because I cast out devils, heal the sick, raise the dead. I haven't done a lot, but I have never cleansed the leper. But it's him in me that does it, but I'm available. Christ in me, the hope of the Lord.
Well, folks, it's just, you never know. Government's sick, not us. There's a lot of people, not one of them in lines wearing a mask. There's not a mask to be seen here. It's KRAZ-TV interviewing down here at Fire Truck Brewing Company. You know, we're making some inroads. There's a lot of different opinions of people here, and I'm trying to do the best I can as a citizen.
That's my face. That's my mask right here. It's my face.
You see what I mean? There's everybody here, and they're expressing their rights and their opinions. And that's what makes America great. Thanks for watching KRAZ-TV. Well, the lone journalist down here at Fire Truck has got this guy's shirt, and it's got a picture of Trump. It says, "Do you miss me now?" Well, who knows? We'll know in 4 more years. You'll wish him back.
Oh, yeah. Let's believe it.
All right. Well, thank you, sir, very much.
You're welcome.
And all great Americans here and patriotic people. And like I said, we don't show anybody's face unless they give us permission and interview. This is KRAZ-TV here, Fire Truck Brewing Company. You want a real success, folks. This has been a real success down here. This place is lined up and packed with folks coming in here. So I don't know if I'm even going to get an interview here with Garrett Lewis, but anyways, they all are wearing MAGA hats and all of that, but we're independent and we show it like it is. I know, the few.
He was talking trash about the ladies this week.
Just showing the shirt. Well, we're going to see if we get an interview with KNST personnel here. But he is just so busy. And they made an announcement over the phone here. But we got hundreds and hundreds of people here. And, yeah, nobody's wearing a mask. Have you got any of those to give away?
I got this actually from Kelly.
I see.
The owner guy, yeah.
Yeah.
He's floating right here. I'll give it to you.
No, that's all right.
Sure?
Yeah. I'm an internet TV station. I want to come down to KNST and get on air and talk because I'm an independent journalist. I've been on for 20 years. I'm probably one of the very first in Arizona and probably in the United States.
All right.
I have 1 million viewers.
Oh, wow.
I have 2,500 videos, and I'm doing the minimal shows right now. It's a family-friendly, G-rated site, and if somebody wants to do an interview, I'd love to do that.
Are you on YouTube?
Yes, I am. Well, I just talked to KNST, and we got a lot of people here.
Parting shot from Food Fire Truck Brewing Company. And that guy's a plumber too. Take care and we'll see y'all. Goodbye.